what first attracted me to this tool is that it really puts the emphasis on the person's functionality, not their diagnosis.
We know instinctually, or in our gut, we like to say, that a person that we're taking care of is very frail and has many things wrong with them, but you can't make decisions on the basis of what your gut is telling you.
There might be someone who appears to be very frail to the eye, but when you do the tool, you have some empirical data that says, actually, it might make sense to do whatever surgery on this person because they're highly functional.
So one of the things we're aiming to achieve with the Frailty Index is to provide the most appropriate care to people. So for some people who are very frail, that will mean withholding expensive, intensive, harmful care from which they are unlikely to benefit.
Cardiac surgery for a 95-year-old who plays tennis two or three times a week may be completely reasonable based on the knowledge that he or she is likely to do quite well